tomato light, tomato light, shining bright in the darkest night. Tomato light, tomato light, shining bright in the darkest night.
In the darkest night.
In the state of North Carolina, near the city of Wilmington, there's a place called Mako Station. That's where this story was begun. In 1867, they say, a locomotive engineer whose name was Joe Baldwin died in a train wreck here. It was just before midnight, so they say, and the night was cold and black. Near the broken rail where the spikes had failed, Joe was standing on the track. The whistle screamed when the headlights gleamed, saw the warning light he gave. But the speeding freight and the hand of fate laid poor Joe in his grave.
The Mako light, the Mako light, shining bright in the darkest night. The Mako light, the Mako light, shining bright
in the darkest night.
In the darkest night.
From that day on, so the story goes, which no one won't deny, there's a ghostly light that appears at night like a halo in the sky. Though many have seen it, who really knows what makes the light appear? The old folks say it's the light of a lantern that Joe was a-swinging here. They say old Joe is surely a ghost that keeps coming back at night, still trying in vain to warn the train with the waving of his light. Well, maybe you believe it, or maybe you don't, or maybe you just won't tell. I've never been to either place, but I know there's a heaven and a hell.
The Mako light, the Mako light, shining bright in the darkest night. The Mako light, the Mako light, shining bright
in the darkest night.
In the darkest night.
If you've strayed from the fold, forgotten your goal, and it seems that you've strayed too far, though your future looks black, you're bound to make it back if you follow
the old North Star.
I often sit and think about the days when I was a boy. And don't you know my old heart beats faster? It's so full of love and joy. I still recall those hounds we had. Let's see, there was Sam and Jake and Rick. Why, sure, I still remember them well, though they've been a long time dead. I still recall those cold winter nights and that great big harvest moon. We'd cross over old Black Mountain and chase ourselves a coon. We'd build a fire, we'd sit around, and Paul would play his old guitar. And then he'd say, boys,
follow the old North Star.
I recall one certain night, it was midnight or somewhere past, and in the west a storm was brewing up, and boy, it came up mighty fast. And it seemed the Lord spoke to us in a thunderous, mighty jar, and he said, boys,
follow the old North Star.
If you strayed from the fold, for God, seems that you strayed too far. Though your future looks black, you're bound to make it back if you follow.